Congressman Madison Cawthorn is no more. He loses his primary, he's out of there, he's gone. Madison Cawthorn, the youngest member of the US Congress, he was anti-black people, anti-LGBTQ community. He was pro-Donald Trump. That's basically all you need to know. He decided to commit the unbelievable sin of actually snitching on other Republicans and exposing their orgies and cocaine parties. That's what did him in. Let me give you some background here. Cawthorn lost his bid for reelection. Let's put up his picture to this guy, all right? Falling to State Senator Chuck Edwards in the GOP primary in the 11th Congressional District. Seven challengers had stepped up to challenge Cawthorn in this deeply red district. He called Edwards to concede Tuesday night, all right? So let's go over this brief but very interesting career of Cawthorn. Cawthorn has twice been stopped trying to bring a gun onto a plane. One of us would have been in prison. He was able to avoid even arrest. He claimed his colleagues take cocaine and hold orgies. That's what did it. Which means, by the way, that his colleagues do use cocaine and have orgies. He suggested House Speaker Nancy Pelosi is an alcoholic, even though she doesn't drink. He might be caught up in an insider trading scheme. And a GOP senator from his own state has called for an investigation into him. He has called the Ukrainian President Zelenskyy a thug. Multiple women have accused him of sexual harassment. It goes on. January 6th, let's go to that. His involvement, a group of Cawthorn's constituents challenged his eligibility to be on the ballot, arguing that he should not be allowed to run because they say the congressman advocated for political violence both before and after January 6, 2021, and that the actions of Cawthorn and others led directly, intentionally, and foreseeably to the insurrectionist violent assault on the Capitol. They were correct. Now, to mention the unflattering photos and videos, let's put up a screenshot of some of those. Take it down memory lane here, all right? This happened after he exposed Republican members of Congress for their cocaine use and sexual orgies, all right? There it is. Despite a last minute endorsement from Trump, he still lost. In recent weeks, Cawthorn faced an onslaught of unflattering opposition and questions about his mental stability. Republican leaders in the state, including Senator Tom Tillis, who backed Edwards, worked to unseat him. Last year, Cawthorn angered Tillis when he called the senator a terrible campaigner and a complete rhino, Republican in name only. At a Republican meeting in the state, Congressman Cawthorn also briefly talked about switching districts, pushing aside and disparaging Tim Moore, the state House Speaker and presumed front runner. Definition of flash in the pan, all right? Cawthorn was dangerous, but the guy who is going to replace him, he's dangerous too. His policies are completely antithetical to progress. He's a ridiculous individual as well, all right? They're just trading pieces at this point. Same play, different person. All right, AB, thoughts here?
Yeah, at this point, I feel like the GOP just needs their own reality show on the Zeus Network because it's just tacky, unorganized, and a complete mess. This is why we have to fight for voting rights. This is why we need to fight and make sure all these gerrymandering laws and stuff that are trying to push us out of these districts don't pass, because this is what we're stuck with leadership. He was 26 years old, clearly didn't know what he was doing. Very immature. It was a lot of stuff about him before he even ran for his position that people should have been concerned about. But this is a rhetoric that has been skewed now. And this is what happens when we don't have a better like standard for who should be in Congress and who should be in leadership. Like, we need to do better background checks on the leadership.
Yeah. This is what happens when the electorate has been conditioned to consume. So because of commercialization, there's this consumerism connected to politics now. So now instead of being a thoughtful voter, instead of being a thoughtful citizen, they want you to be a thoughtless consumer. And as long as the brand is smoking, if the brand is hot, people are going to consume or vote. for that brand, especially in the Republican Party. But this also permeates in left-leaning politics as well. And it takes intentional effort, like what we're doing here, to expose it and to be thoughtful about the analysis, narrative, and conversation.